This is Sincere TV.
Let's see who's under the bathroom mat. It's Ray Davies. Or to be more precise, Sir Raymond Douglas Davies, CBE. The E is silent. Born the 21st of June, 1944, in Fortis Green, North London, Ray had six older sisters and one younger brother, Dave. By all accounts, Ray is extremely difficult to work with and profoundly frugal, but he did write my favorite song. Without Ray Davies, there would be no Jam. I'm gonna take money and I take away curry. I'm on the way home to my wife. She'll be lining up the cutlery and now she's expecting me. Polishing her glasses and pulling out the cork. I'm down in a two-station at midnight. Madness.
Our house in the middle of our street.
Or Blur. What's that you say? All English bands? That's right. There's no songwriter more English than Ray Davies, and no band more English than the Kinks. Ray was the vocalist, rhythm guitarist, of his band The Kinks, with his brother Dave on lead guitar and backing vocals, Pete Quaife on bass guitar, and Mick Avery on drums. The night Ray was born, there was a German air raid in London, and it blew out all the windows in their living room. Ray's dad, Fred, worked as a cattleman at a London meat market, and as a result, they always had meat, even during wartime rationing. Every Saturday night, there would be a knees up at the Davis's house on Denmark Terrace. The family and friends would get around the piano, have a few drinks, and sing a few songs. They were singing one night when the lead singer broke a front tooth on the microphone and ran off stage. Dave nudged his brother towards the microphone, and that was how Ray became the lead singer.
Gonna tell Aunt Mary about Uncle John. He says he got the blues, but he has a lot of fun, oh baby.
The first Kinks single, cover of Little Richard's Long Tall Sally, barely made the UK top 50, but You Really Got Me went to number one in the UK and number seven in the US. It was written on a piano, as were most of Ray's songs, the same one that was in the Davies family's living room.
Sincere TV.
Ray's brother Dave invented the distorted electric guitar sound that has been used to varying degrees by every rock guitarist since. Both Ray and Dave still claim that they got that sound by slashing the speaker cone in his guitar amp with a razor blade. The razor blade story is great, but they actually got the sound by feeding the output of Dave's small guitar amp into a much larger guitar amp. Dave's small amp was basically the first fuzz box. And whenever you see your favorite guitarist with an array of pedals at his feet, there's a pretty good chance one of them is a fuzz box or a distortion pedal. With the same sound and feel as its predecessor, All Day and All of the Night was another massive hit, getting to number 2 in the UK and number 7 in the US. Tired of Waiting in 1965 was actually the first song Ray wrote, but it was left unfinished, and he wrote a lot of it on the train ride to the studio on the day they were due to record it, and then finished the lyrics during a coffee break. Kinks were banned from performing and touring in the US from 1965 to 1969, the peak of the so-called British invasion. Ray attributes the ban to a combination of bad luck, bad management, and bad behavior. To be successful in the States, British bands had to play ball with the media and the press. The Beatles were very good at this, and they actually seemed to like it. The Kinks didn't, and they were having none of it. The ban eliminated any chance of success in the States for those 4 years, and stuck in England, Ray started writing about things a little closer to home.
'Cause he gets up in the morning, and he goes to work at 9, and he comes back home at 5:30, gets the same train every time, 'cause his world is built on punctuality.
For a well-respected man, Ray drops the American singing accent and the influence from American rock and roll, and presented a much more English style of singing and presentation.
They seek him here, they seek him there, his clothes are loud, but never square.
1966, dedicated follower of fashion, was mocking the fashion-conscious swinging London of the times. Ray got into an argument with somebody at a party over his flared trousers, rushed home angry, and knocked out the whole song from start to finish on a typewriter. The song starts with a quote from the 1905 novel, The Scarlet Pimpernel. They seek him here, they seek him there.
No previous international, no other cup final, indeed nothing Wembley ever staged, matched the glamour of this event, the final of the World Cup.
1966 was another great year for the Kinks, and a great year for England, especially the English football team, who won the World Cup at Wembley Stadium. They famously sang Sunny Afternoon after the game in the baths. British taxes during that time were outrageously high, 50% up to a certain threshold, and then 95% above. Most pop stars at the time well exceeded that threshold. Ray's attitude in the video is fantastic, and I think it reflects his disdain for the British government. The Beatles were complaining about it 2 months later with their song Taxman.
People live on Indian Street.
Another hit from that year was Dead End Street, which Ray says is a song about the death of pop culture. The BBC banned it because they deemed the video to be in poor taste.
Yes, it's number one, it's Top of the Pops.
As a young boy growing up in the 60s, I was used to seeing the Kinks every Thursday night on Top of the Pops. And in 1967, I watched them perform Waterloo Sunset, and I have this enduring image of this grainy black and white TV set with the Kinks singing my favorite song.
Dirty old river, must you keep rolling, rolling into the night? People so busy, make me feel dizzy, taxi light shines so bright.
Sunset, it's got a real feeling of longing about it for something that's only just gone.
There's something so deeply moving about the song and so timeless.
To convey a situation and emotions and people's feelings and the ordinary person in the street's feelings.
Without doubt, one of our leading songwriters. Always has been, and I believe always will be.
Autumn Almanac was a song inspired by a gardener with a very bad back in his Muswell Hill neighbourhood of North London.
From the Tussaud hedge creeps the chronic caterpillar. When the dawn begins to crack, it's all part of my awesome almanac.
Dave says that during this period, Ray would often take the tape off of the tape recorder in the recording studio and play it backwards to see if he could find any hidden melodies to use as a bridge or a chorus. And in the case of Autumn Almanac, he had originally written a song called This Is My Street, which is the bridge of the song. But if you reverse the bridge, not only does the melody for Autumn Almanac emerge, but the words Autumn Almanac emerge too, which is mind-blowing. But look at this. Days was originally written for their next album, but it was rushed out as a single, but it only reached number 12 in the UK and didn't even dent the US charts.
Thank you for the day, those endless days of sacred days you gave me.
Ray wrote this song for his sister Rosie, who had emigrated to Australia. It's clearly a song about farewells, and Ray dedicated it to Pete Quaife, the bass player of the Kinks, when he performed it at Glastonbury in 2010. Ray has requested that it be played at his funeral.
What's wrong with being sexy? I mean, there's no
sexist.
The Kinks Are the Village Preservation Society was their sixth studio album, and upon its release, it failed to chart in the UK and the US. Described by some critics as a concept album, Ray says it's simply a collection of character studies.
Picture yourself.
you found your paradise.
While on tour, the Davis brothers visited their sister in the suburbs of Adelaide, where they lived in a semi-detached house in an area which was known as a designed community. The song is based on an experience Ray had one night in a London club, but he's never been very forthcoming with all the details. Once again, it's groundbreaking material and made the Beatles and the Stones seem a little bit like Disney at the time. Ray had to fly back to London from New York, where they were just about to start a tour, to change the vocal from Coca-Cola to Cherry Cola, in order to avoid a ban from the non-commercial policy of the BBC. Like all of these Kinks songs, Lola features the wonderful combination of Ray and Dave's voices. In 1970's Ape Man, Ray is once again searching for paradise by sailing away to a distant shore to make like an ape man. And unbelievably, Ray had to return from New York to London once again to re-record the vocal, because the line, "the air pollution is a fogging up my eyes," was considered by the BBC to be too close to "the air pollution is a fucking up my eyes." Pollution is a fogging up my eyes. I wanna get out of this city alive. In 1972, Ray was still searching for paradise, this time in a supersonic rocket ship, where nobody has to be hip, nobody's gonna travel second class, and there'll be equality and no suppression of minorities. In the late 1970s, when punk rock exploded in the UK, the Kinks were looking old and well past their sell-by date, just like the Beatles, the Stones, Led Zeppelin, Yes, and all their prog rockin' pals. They were dismissed as boring old farts. Ex-CBS record executive Clive Davis had just formed his new Arista Records, and he signed the Kinks because he thought they could still be a very successful stadium rock band in the US. He was right, he usually is, and they started performing in front of hundreds of thousands of both old and new fans, and sold boatloads of albums in the US. Come Dancing did nothing in the UK when it was initially released in 1982. Clive Davis thought the lyrics were too parochial and British and refused to release it as a single in the US. They put a parking lot on a piece of land where the supermarket used to stand. However, with the help of a brilliant video on MTV and also impressive sales of import singles, he eventually relented. The single reached number 6 in the US, and when it was re-released in the UK, it got to number 12. My friends used to come and call, why not come dancing? It's only natural. The song was written as a tribute to Ray's sister, Renee, who had emigrated to Canada with her husband. On one of her trips back to London, Ray's 13th birthday, she surprised him with a gift of the Spanish guitar that Ray had been trying to persuade his parents to buy him. That evening, Renee, who had a weak heart as a result of a childhood bout of rheumatic fever, went off dancing and had a fatal heart attack at the Lyceum Ballroom in the Strand in central London. She died in the arms of a stranger. It is time for you to stop. Ray's songs have been covered by many great bands, The Pretenders covered Stop Your Sobbing on their first album, and then they also covered I Go to Sleep on their second album. She and Ray had a relationship which produced their daughter, Natalie Ray Hind. Although Van Halen made some great records, this isn't one of them. It's stodgy and pedestrian. Don't forget that Dave is really, really good, and not all guitarists can play this riff with any conviction. Ray says his brother has the left hand of a boxer. The Jam recorded a tighter, tougher version of David Watts for their 1978 masterpiece, All Mod Cons. Kirsty MacColl's cover of Days is possibly the best cover of any of Ray's songs.
Thank you for the days, those endless days, those sacred days you gave me.
It reached number 12 in the UK, but did nothing in the US, where we were all still too busy rocking to Van Halen. Ray was knighted by the Queen in 2017 for services to the arts, making him a Sir. The Kinks had 17 top 20 singles in the UK, 5 top 10 albums, 4 of them gold. In the US, they had 5 top 10 singles on the Billboard chart, 9 top 40 albums, and were inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. In total, they've sold 50 million records worldwide. Thanks for watching. You've been Under the Bathroom Mat on Sincere TV with me, Tim Sincere.